Hey at Willie's Place from the Nickel Jukebox. We're going to keep the music going. From Cross Corner, Texas, here's Willie.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again.
Deep in the heart of Texas, with Dallas and Fort Worth to the north and Waco and San Antonio to the south, you'll find Willie's Place. It's now a state-of-the-art truck stop and entertainment facility named after a regular customer and fabled owner, Willie Nelson. This spot was known for decades as Carl's Corner, founded by and named after Carl Cornelius, a local truck stop owner and longtime friend of Willie Nelson. Legend has it that Cornelius, mayor of Carl's Corner, Texas, USA, supposedly wagered his infamous truck stop on a losing poker hand to Willie Nelson.
Hey, this is Kilroy at Willie's Place in Carl's Corner, Texas, and I got to tell you something. That was Willie Nelson on the road again, and we're on the road all the time, 24 hours a day. You can't outrun us. You'll run out of fuel before you run out of XM13, I'll guarantee you, because we're here for you. Come on and visit us at Willie's Place, Carl's Corner, Texas.
Carl Cornelius' respect for truckers began when he got his first CB radio.
Oh, back in 1979, I got a little old CB radio I made from a kit. And I was listening to Truckers Talk. They didn't have any place to stop. And I didn't have any money or anything like that. And so I had big dreams. So I was reading the newspaper one day in Dallas Morning News. And then I looked in there and it had 1,800 acres for sale down here.
Carl found the property where he wanted to build his dream truck stop.
So I went up to Robert Allen White, we call him Monk White's place, and I said, I want to buy your property. And he said, well, I'll sell it.
And he said, what do you want for it? I said, $800 an acre. He said, I'll pay that. I said, okay, we're doing well. And then I said, how much will you pay me down? He said, nothing. And he said, and I don't want to make my first payment for 6 months.
And he looked at me like I was nuts. And I'm sitting there with holes in my Levi's and holes in my shoes. Didn't have a quarter in my damn pocket. And I told him my dream of what I want to do and everything, build a little city down here. And he couldn't get over the point of nothing down for 18 months holding this property. And I asked him for releases contiguous from no individual part anywhere. You know, and so I said, well, I'm sorry to take your time like this. And he said, Carl, I'll do it.
We shook hands. And I sold it to him. Nothing down, $800 an acre, and away we went.
The original truck stop opened in 1984 and was a popular stop for truckers traveling between Dallas and Austin, a drive that was tedious, uneventful, and often bumper to bumper. The original advertising consisted of a woman called Treasure Chest talking directly to truckers on a CB radio, sweetly enticing them to come on by. As the word of this unique truck stop spread, Carl decided that it needed a few more amenities for truckers. And that's when he added a swimming pool.
Carl was always inventive. When he came up with an idea, we never knew what it was going to be. And the first idea he had was truckers never have a swimming pool. So right in the middle of the truck stop, Carl built a huge swimming pool.
And I listened to the CB and find out what the truckers wanted, and I built a truck stop with a hot tub, swimming pool, the whole works, did everything they asked for, trying to complement, make it be an attribute to the trucking industry.
He then had a trucker's drive-in on the drawing board where the truckers could pull their 18-wheelers in when they're tired and watch drive-in movies. He had a trucker's chapel. As you well know, Carl is, I believe, an ordained preacher. Carl has a very, very varied background, and he can give you a line of talk faster than any man I've ever known.
Carl had dreams of expanding the truck stop to include a trucker's bank, a trucker's cemetery, and a trucker's chapel. He really wanted to cater to the trucker's every need. So, how did Willie Nelson figure into all of this? According to Willie, he was traveling down I-35 when he saw his own likeness advertising the truck stop.
Well, I was driving down the highway and I looked up and there was a big sign up there. It had a picture of Carl, it had a picture of me, and it had a picture of Zeke. And I said, well, of course, I'd never met Carl and I didn't know anything about the truck stop or Carl's Corner or anything. But it didn't take long for me to realize that Zeke's back working again.
Yes, Willie's school friend Zeke was also a friend of Carl Cornelius.
One of my friends that I played poker with and was Zeke Vornan, one of Willie's oldest friends. And Zeke used to go with Willie on the weekends and drink. Well, Willie would hock his guitar on a Monday and Zeke would get it out on a Friday so they could play again, you know.
Well, I knew Zeke back when I was in high school. And he used to come to a place that I was playing in the band. And he was a big fan, and we hit it off good. We became great friends. And Zeke was one of those hustlers. I mean, he played all games, poker to pool, whatever. But he had these schemes, you know.
Well, back then, Willie was kind of clean cut, and I was a hoodlum, so I didn't care for him that much, you know, so because he wore suits and ties back then. But anyway, Zeke brought Willie by.
A friendship was born that has endured more than a quarter of a century.
They played poker together, dominoes and poker. I mean, well, you know, I lost the truck stop to him two or three times, won it back, and I won his golf course once, twice, you know, and he gets it back. So now he's got the truck stop, and every time he bets the truck stop, I just fold because I don't want it back like that. You know, I'm just a part owner, you know.
The 10-foot-tall dancing frogs that stood high atop the truck stop have achieved icon status in Texas. These roadside landmarks came from the roof of Tango, a nightclub on Lower Greenville Avenue in Dallas. They were created by artist Bob Daddy-O Wade.
The end of the trail comes through those kind of places, then somebody else gets it. So luckily, because of Monk White and he knew Carl, of course, and was part of this early development of this crazy place. The frogs luckily ended up here. I mean, I don't know where else they could have gone that would have been better than Carl's Corners. And, you know, they've been here since, well, you know, a long time.
Bob was also the creator of the big cowboy boot across from the airport in San Antonio and the giant iguana on top the Lone Star Cafe in New York City. The frogs were purchased by Carl for $6,000 when the nightclub was going under. And once perched atop the truck stop, became a beacon calling out to Texas travelers to stop in and have a cup of coffee.
I saw the dancing frogs is how come I stopped. I had to end the billboard with the thing, but we didn't realize that they hadn't asked Willie about putting his name on it. So Willie's thing, because for years and years and years and years, we always, this is an area where we always stop either down at Abbott at the turkey shop or the Czech stop. So when he opened up this place, oh, we got another place to go.
The famous frogs were among the only pieces saved from the big fire that burned the truck stop down in August of 1990.
When the fire came and it was just this huge disaster, they had several fundraisers for Carl, had one big one in Dallas, and one of the fundraising ways was to sell, do you really need six frogs? There's three in that. So three of the frogs are now in the possession of Chuy's restaurants, and three are down, I mean, that three are down in Chuy's in Houston, and three are here.
I got here about an hour after it burned to the ground, and Willie's bus got here about the same time. And we all looked at it. We opened the safe where there was $10,000. And we went over to Willie's place in Abbott and started playing dominoes and figuring out how we were going to rebuild it.
The truck stop never fully recovered from the fire, but there were many key people that wanted to see it survive. These people included Willie Nelson, Monk White, Steve Gilcrease, and Dennis McLaughlin, CEO of Earth Biofuels, Inc. They, along with Carl Cornelius, formed Truckers Corner LP in order to rebuild this trucker's refuge. Plans for the new Willie's Place began. We'll be back with more from Willie's Place and a look at BioWillie, the biodiesel fuel marketed by Willie Nelson. Keep it here on RFD TV. Willie Nelson first learned about biodiesel in 2004 from his wife Annie when she bought a car that could run on alternative fuel.
The next morning Willie called me and said, "Hey, have you ever heard of biodiesel?" I said, "No, not really." And he said, "Well," he told me the story about Annie and the Volkswagen over there and running biodiesel.
Come to find out it was a good idea, and the idea spread around the country. The truckers are the ones who have really put the word out because they try it, they like it, and they tell somebody about it.
And I said, "Willie, you really believe in it?" He said, "Yeah." And he said, "I like to keep the truck stop open and put one lane in there." And I said, "Well, hell, you really believe in it?" He said, "Yeah." And I said, "Well, let's just make it totally biodiesel." He said, "Let's go for it." So we did, and it was really good. The truckers loved it. The motor cooled down. We got more miles per gallon. The vibration ceased. The algae was eaten up by the biodiesel. First time they could see the bottom of their tanks in years, you know.
Well, I think by now everyone that I know in the music business that has buses, trucks, cars, whatever, realizes the importance of switching over to some kind of alternative fuels because they've heard about it. Most musicians are more familiar with what's really going on inside the country than a lot of people because we go up and down the highway talking to farmers, truckers. And so most of these guys realize that biodiesel is the way to go.
The excitement about BioWillie and the support from Earth Biofuels helped fuel the rebuilding of the truck stop. It is now state of the art.
We was going to remodel the old truck stop, and all of a sudden we started tearing down everything but the theater. And then we started fixing the theater up. David Anderson, Willie's manager, road manager, was here, and he kind of helped design the thing. And
it's one of the best honky tonks around. We've got a huge dance floor and all sorts of configurations and a lot of memorabilia and stuff for Willie, and tried to make it an attraction, especially with the XM radio here.
It's obvious that Willie had a hand in the design. Near backstage, there is a bus barn where his tour bus can pull in, then be completely camouflaged from the outside world, allowing Willie or the other artists who will perform here an uninterrupted walk directly to the stage.
It is Willie's place. It's been a virtual world, and now it's a real place that people can come and talk to Kilroy and Catfish and be a part of it.
Carl has big dreams.
You know, Willie a long time ago looked at me and said, "Carl, why don't we just build a club across the street and give half of it to George Strait?" And he had to play there 6 times a year. And his agent booked it the rest of the time, and he owns half, we own half. We'll build one for Merle Haggard, and, you know, Waylon was alive then, and, you know, Reba McIntyre, Emmylou Harris, or whoever, you know. And he said, "Girl, we'll have a blankety-blank Branson, Missouri before you know it." You know, and so I have never lost that concept in my mind. And he planted the seed, and I think it's going to happen.
When Monk and I were first coming down here, Carl's finally had a place where he had some kind of office, and he had just dozens of these big, thick books everywhere. This one was about electrical. This one was about concrete. I mean, all these do-it-yourself deals. I mean, this guy can, you know, if he doesn't know how to do it, he'll go find out how to do it. He's just one of those old-timey Texas-style survivors, entrepreneur, get it done, you know, whatever it takes.
Carl has worked harder than any man I've ever known to keep his vision alive. And don't ever count him out. That's Carl Cornelius.
The success of the new Willie's Place will hinge on its 24/7 promotion from the Willie's Place channel on XM Satellite Radio, where traditional country music is played 24 hours a day. Eddie Kilroy oversaw the building of this million-dollar radio studio inside Willie's Place.
First of all, this XM Satellite Radio has always been completely over the top in technology, and everything is state-of-the-art, all digital. The room was designed to flow with the ambiance of a honky-tonk, and it's not the typical radio station, which we're not a radio station, but it's not the typical studio you'd go into. Willie's Place is where genuine country music still lives, and that's why the average listener listens 10 and a half hours. Because they know when they go to Willie's Place, they're going to hear Ray Price, they're going to hear Willie or Johnny Bush or Daryl McCall or something really good country, and it sounds the same pretty much whenever you come in here. The only thing that changes is the personalities that are on the air. The image that we always painted that this was a Texas honky-tonk, now it really is a living Texas honky-tonk.
Willie says he's glad that Willie's Place on XM Satellite has a home here, where we can let the rest of the world know where they can come to find good music and BioWillie fuel.
The whole picture, the whole idea is working. A biodiesel plant, a truck stop, and an interstate. We need 500 of these all over the United States, and we can quit being so dependent on foreign energy.
We'll be back with more from Willie's Place and music from Willie's Picnic. Stay with us on RFD TV. Carl Cornelius' property adjacent to the truck stop was the site of several famous Willie Nelson 4th of July picnics dating back to the 1980s.
Our first picnic in 1987, and I loved it. It was a new experience for me because I don't go anywhere. I think going to Hillsborough is a trip to me, you know, to go to the golf course.
While Willie's Picnic has been held in many locations, there are a few performers that have been constants. Legends Merle Haggard and Ray Price.
Well, you know, I've always loved Ray Price's singing, and I started writing songs for a publishing company that he owned, Pamper Music in Goodlettsville, Tennessee, right outside of Nashville. And one day out on the highway, he was out traveling, touring, and his bass player, a guy named Donnie Young, who later changed his name to Johnny Paycheck, quit the band. So Ray called me and asked me if I could play bass. And I said, of course, can't everybody? And I'd never played bass before in my life. But on the way to the first gig, which was in Patsy Cline's hometown in Virginia, Jimmy Day, great musician, steel guitar player, could play anything. He taught me to play bass between there and the first gig. And I went over Ray's songs that he was going to do on the show. And I thought I had pulled it off pretty well until later I found out Ray knew.
Deep within my heart lies a melody, a song of old San Antonio, where in dreams I live with a memory. Beneath the stars all along, it was there I found, beside the Alamo, enchantment strange as the blue up above, a moonlit path that only she would know. Still here's my broken song of love. Moon in all your splendor goes only my heart. Call back my rose, rose of San Antonio. A lip so sweet and tender, like petals falling apart. Speak once again of my love, my own broken song. Dear words I know, still live in my heart all alone. For that moonlit path beside the Alamo, and rose my rose of San Antonio.
could be holding you tonight. Could do wrong, start doing right. You don't care about what I think. Think I'll just stay here and drink. Putting you down don't square the deal. Least you know the way I feel. Take all the money in the bank. Think I'll just stay here and drink. Listen close, you can hear that loud jukebox playing in my ear. And a woman gonna change the way I think. Think I'll just stay here and drink. Just stay here and hang. Fiddle it.
This crowd sees a familiar face at Carl's Corner, the new Willie's place, Willie himself.
Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. They'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys ain't easy to love and they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds and gold. Lone Star belt buckles and old faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. And if you don't understand him and he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. They'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Cowboys like smoky old pool rooms and clear mountain mornings. Little warm puppies and children and girls of the night. Them that don't know him won't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take it. He ain't wrong, he's just different, but his pride won't let him do things to make you think he's right. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Let them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mama, don't let your cowboys grow up to be babies. They'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. baby, I didn't love you. Quite as often as I could have. And maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. If I made you feel second best, girl, I'm sorry I was blind. My mind, you were always on my mind. Maybe I didn't hold you all those lonely, lonely times. I guess I never told you. I'm so happy that you're mine. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Tell me. Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died. And give me one more chance to keep you satisfied. I'll keep you satisfied. Said and done, I just never took the time. You were always on my mind. 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 Thank you very much.
Thanks for coming along with us to Willie's Place. We hope to see you on the road again.
Hey, Cooter tells me I gotta go get in the truck. Cooter, we gotta get out of here because there comes a time for the paw to paw, the pine to pine, the sun sinks low, and that old milk cow heads for the house. And I'm doing the same thing. I'm cold trailing you, baby. God bless you.
My friend.